For this tutorial, I will be using a web service from this site. It'll be this stock code web service. So I'll copy the visitor location. And let's quickly take a look at this file. Next, let me double check that I have this version of Java set up on my machine. So I will need to use this tool, WS import, and we use it in order to parse WSDL files and generate JAX WS artifacts. So keep means keep the generated Java file, and S is going to specify the directory where the generated Java files are going to be placed, and this is WSDL, http://www.webserviceX.com/stockcode. So let's go here to that directory. Here we go, the code got generated. So let's copy these files. And I will go to Eclipse and create a new project. And here I'll create a package. And I'll drop the Java files here. And I'll create another class, let's call it driver. It's gonna have a main method, and I'll put it in this package com.va.tutorial.webservices. Now we're looking at the classes that got generated. We have stock code and stock code soap, and stock code soap has a get code method that would return the code for a specific stock. And the way I would obtain this stock code soap is from stock code. So it has get stock code soap. So basically in the driver, what I will be doing is will obtain this stock code soap from instantiating a stock code and then calling the get stockcode soap method on it. And this will be a simple command line application, so I will need to be able to read what the user enters on the command line. So I'll pass in system.n to a new input stream reader and pass that to a buffered reader new instance. And then put myself in a while always true loop. So asking the user to please enter stock symbol or queue to quit. And let me define stock symbol up here. And read the symbol that the user enters. So buffered reader dot read line. And go ahead and break if the user enters queue for quit. Otherwise, I will use a web service in order to obtain a code for that stock. So I'll print that out. So stock symbol, and this will be stock code soap dot get code. And pass in the symbol that the user entered. And let's go ahead and test run the application. So this will be Google. So what we got back is stock code, stock symbol, Google, and etc. So we got back all the data for Google. Let's do IBM. Same thing. Go ahead and quit.